The year is 1942, the 20th of August. The Swedish diplomat Göran von Otter is traveling from Warsaw to Berlin on the night train. But the train is fully booked, so he cannot get a sleeping compartment. On the same train is SS officer Kurt Gerstein, also unable to book a compartment. On a dark platform, catching some air, von Otter offers the nervous SS man a cigarette. Gerstein, finding out that von Otter is a Swedish diplomat, asks if he can talk to him at the legation. Von Otter suggests they talk on the train instead. In the corridor of a railway car between Warsaw and Berlin, they have a long conversation. Exactly how that conversation went, we cannot know. But the report Kurt wrote in 1945, before he most likely committed suicide, would give a good hint. There should also be a letter written by von Otter about the meeting in 1945. Kurt had just visited extermination camp Belzec. Kurt Gerstein explains to Göran von Otter how a train with Jews arrives, with many already dead inside. All are forced to undress, moved into a chamber. Outside, an SS man says, "Breathe deeply for disinfection." "No, no, only the men will work. Women can work if they want to." The doors are then closed, but the engine supposed to be used to kill all the people inside via carbon monoxide does not start. 2 hours and 49 minutes later, they get it going. 32 minutes after that, all are dead inside. Gerstein used a stopwatch during all this time. Göran von Otter said that Kurt had a purpose in talking to him, and at some point it was hard to keep him from raising his voice. He was nervous, cried, showed despair. He wanted the Allies to know what was happening so they could send leaflets over Germany and get the German people to revolt against their current regime and put a stop to it. Von Otter, afraid that he might be a provocateur, asked for documentation, which Gerstein showed him. Arriving in Berlin, they part ways. Von Otter goes up to legation. As far as is known, he is told not to write down the meeting or what was talked about in a report. Instead, he is supposed to give the report verbally the next time he is in Stockholm. 4 months later, he is finally in the Swedish capital, and he makes his report at the Foreign Department. If that was only verbally or also in writing is uncertain. Up until this date, no written report have been found. What is known is that the information about the Holocaust is never forwarded to any Allied countries. The Holocaust was not unknown at the time. What perhaps was not known was the use of gas to kill people, or to have such a detailed description from an SS officer. Göran von Otter goes on with his diplomatic career. Gerstein stays in the SS until the end of the war. In 1945, Kurt Gerstein is captured. He writes down his report and after that hangs himself. Von Otter has sent a letter regarding the information Kurt Gerstein had provided to him to the London embassy, hoping that it would get forwarded to the authorities holding Kurt Gerstein, feeling that the story about the meeting with Gerstein should be told. But the letter came after Gerstein was dead. Von Otter was deeply troubled about the story, and if you read Gerstein's report, you will be also. He continued speaking out for Gerstein and helped to have his name cleared in 1965. Would this information have made any difference if it would have reached the Allies? Unfortunately, the answer is probably not. The information available in 1942 and after did not change the war effort, and what was published did not change Hitler's mind. That said, the information should have been forwarded, because even if it probably would not have made any difference, it just might have. This is the story about how a Swedish diplomat met the SS man who told him all about the Holocaust.